This is for Monday, the 7th of December, 2020. My name is Collins, and I've come to bother you again with something I don't think I've talked about before, that is economics. I am not an economist. You could probably have guessed that already. The idea of making money without producing anything has never appealed to me. Investing in stock markets and owning property because it's bound to increase in value, or having a retirement plan that's managed by some financial smarties. I never really caught into the idea of playing the markets, because it felt like a game of chance, like gambling. Because it is gambling, I guess that's why it feels that way. And it's not just gambling that I don't like. I don't really like games. I don't like anything, any activity that doesn't produce anything. I don't like getting involved in something that you can win or lose just for the fun of it or for financial gain, because it doesn't make anything. I like to make things. So this is getting to the description of why I'm not a rich man. I guess it's just a matter of taste. Now, the trouble is that most of society is arranged on the basis of these principles that I kind of find distasteful. I only want to make money by the sweat of my brow, so to speak. But that's not enough money in this life, really. In this life, you're expected not just to work to support yourself, but to become a participant in some kind of great game. And if you don't play, then it's like there's something wrong with you. That's how I was made to feel growing up. Our baseline costs of living are shaped by that expectation. Let's say you want to buy a house or a car, or you want to send your kid to university. You're not supposed to just pay for those things. You're supposed to borrow money and pay interest on it. The prices of things are set such that it must be that way. Unless you're quite rich, you don't just save up and buy something. You're supposed to get it now and pay for it for the rest of your life. That's the way I understand it. And that's how the rich get richer. Think about retirement. The expectation is that you will live beyond your productive years and that those remaining years shouldn't be miserable. Good. Hence the idea of the old age pension. You accumulate some wealth and then you stop working and spend that money until you die. Now, where that money comes from depends on what kind of economy you live in. Some of it may come from taxes and that you pay, and some of it just might be some of your own pay that you invest in your retirement. And because of the borrowing and lending interest game, your money makes money just by being money. And I'm like, huh? It's another thing I could never really wrap my head around. I mean, like, why retire? Why can't I just work until I'm not useful anymore and then die? Of course, now that I'm becoming less relevant, that question is harder to answer. But that's the personal side of it. There's also a macro side of it, like a systemic side. Businesses usually get started nowadays by means of venture capital, meaning that people who have money for whatever reason will invest money in the company, and then they own pieces of it, they own shares of it. And those shares may grow in value. At some point, the company may go public, so to speak, and then all kinds of people can own shares in the company. These shareholders are taught to expect that the value of the shares will grow. If the company's earnings are sustainable but flat, that is, they could go on for 100 years like this and everything would be fine, that's not good enough. Everything is supposed to grow or else there's something wrong with it. Those, as I understand it, are the rules of capitalism. But, of course, I'm not an economist. But this has, in my opinion, some deleterious effects on the management of companies. on the decisions and actions of the businesses. Their policies get wagged, not just by fear of the shareholders, but by fear of the analysts and commentators in the financial sector, whose role is more or less the same as the people who announce a football game, except that their game is a little more speculative. It is their business to manipulate business by sculpting the psychology around it. Then the articles and bylaws of the corporation sort of take on a life of their own. It's like they become an incorporeal creature that makes all the big decisions so that the humans are not to blame. You can swap out a CEO in the blink of an eye, I've seen it happen, just because the growth figures are the wrong size. And the end result is there's no such thing as just doing business anymore. And moreover, the business is not so much about production anymore. It's not making things that people need is just a smaller part of what we think of when we say business. It's a lot more of it is about financial markets and Wall Street and stuff like that. And gambling. I don't know if you've noticed, there's something called eToro, which is an online investing platform, as I understand it. And lately they've been advising us that there's a resurgence in the value of single-use plastics, and that that might be a good thing to invest in. So here you have a company, eToro, which is, seems to be advising people to invest in one of the nightmare industries of the world. I mean, something that we should be working to annihilate. Instead, they're telling us to go make money off of it, because you can make money off of bad things. And that's the kind of stuff that I just can't get on board with. I make money without doing anything off of something that's going to be evil. I guess it's just a matter of taste, but, you know, I can't go there. I like to think that these are some of the reasons why I'll never be rich. Of course, there are other reasons. I mean, I'm not smart, I'm not pretty, I'm not practical, and I'm not a genius. I'm the sort of person who just wants to work to make a living, and I think that's my fatal flaw. And I like my fatal flaw. Okay, thanks for hearing me out. That's all I have to say about that. Do you have anything to say about that or something else? I'm right there. If things go well, I'll be back to talk to you with more bullshit next Monday. In the meantime, I hope that you and all those dollars will have a fine avondverder.
Get off.